Hello and welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to the status report highlight for the 21st of June, 2016. And as version 6.0 containing the new renderer has been released on Stable Branch, the team keeps pushing towards beta. In this status report, we have Brian, Victor, and Andre commenting on subjects such as the milestone goals going towards 0.6.1, the new audio module, and of course, more of those sweet animations that are coming up. As Hixie's sure most of us already know, 6.0 build was moved to Stable Branch last week during E3. It is but one step towards 1.0, but one that the whole team were all excited to get into our hands. While the build has been enjoyed by over 400,000 people since hitting Stable Branch, the team have been keeping an eye on issues present on the build, and have been working towards a hotfix for the most critical issues, while also moving forward on 0.6.1. Current top issues for our hotfix are AI-related server crash, container lifetime refresh issue, known duplication methods, and vehicle location or position persistence. With those being worked on, the milestone goals for 6.0 have been achieved, and the team look forward to their goals of 0.6.1. All 6.0 build milestone goals which were implemented are new renderer, randomized attachments and items random, new reload mechanics, and 60 player per instance, or 60 slot servers. Current 6.1 milestone goals are server logging queue, merge of new audio technology from Armor 3 Eden update, update of weapon sounds for new audio technology, dynamic spawning of infected, and of course one of my most anticipated milestones for 6.1, the wolves. If you missed my previous video on Armor 3 gun game, here's a little snippet showing off some Armor 3 Eden update audio technology. And finally from Hicks, he will be at RTX in Austin, Texas early next month to talk about 6.1 and show some early representations of some of the systems, as well as a recap of 6.0 and what was achieved there. For those not attending the show, we'll be recording the audio off the soundboard and we'll match it with the presentation media and upload to our YouTube channel. I will most likely get coverage from it on my channel also, just in case you miss it on the official DayZ Dev Team's YouTube channel. And lastly, we'll be experimenting with uploads to our DayZ Dev Team YouTube channel at 4K on the new NVIDIA GTX 1080 card. So for those eager to see how that performs on 6.0, keep an eye out for that. A massive thanks from all of us at the DayZ Dev Team to those participating in the early access period, and especially to the 415,000 who have joined us in testing 6.0 over the last 2 weeks. Now let's see what Victor has to say regarding animations. In the past few weeks, there have been some cool animations finished. To mention some of them, we have now attaching and detaching doors of her vehicles, new reload animations including Winchester, and there is also a complete new reload for the M249. The infected have received idle variations and a few different door attacks. The upcoming player character can hold items and aim using new aim spaces. We are still polishing existing animations for changing stances and movements. The way the character reacts to controls is great. The fact that we can blend multiple animations means it's fluent, not limiting, and it looks much better. For instance, you can start running and go to crouch at the same time, and you can raise your weapon as well. Or you can change your mind and go back to the original pose, all in the transition itself, without any limitation or interruption. There is still a lot in front of us for the new player controller, from small tasks to complex features. In the next few weeks, we will focus on improving dynamics for character locomotion, finish camera behavior, and start implementing new reload animations. Sadly, this week we don't have any new footage of said animations. Hopefully we get to see them maybe over the next few weeks, like Victor says. So keep an eye on the DayZ Trello, which will be linked in the description below. And if you don't see it on there, of course, I will put it on my channel for you all to see. Now let's see what Andre has to say about the audio. After a long silence from the audio department, you see what you did there? Andre is delighted he can talk about some big improvements and upgrades we have planned moving towards 6.1. Our programmers worked hard on implementing our new audio system, which will also be the core of the Enfusion audio. In the coming updates, we will have completely new gunshot sounds with new distance parameters and attenuation and frequency curves, which are enormous improvements over existing ones. We will be able to distinguish distance and position of the shots fired with greater precision. Also, new sound effects we made are better quality and have greater diversity, so you can recognize which type of weapon is firing more easily. In the coming updates, we also plan to consecutively upgrade ambient sounds, which will be an enormous core upgrade, but also vehicle sounds, melee and all character sounds that will complement the new character animations you've been told about. So, with the new Enfusion audio, I did not expect new ambient sounds, vehicle sounds, melee and character sounds to accompany the animations. That is some really exciting news. Let me know in the comments below your thoughts on all of these. I am really excited, just as much excited about the audio as I was with the renderer. I am pretty hyped. All links, as always, will be in the description below. Let's have a conversation in the comments below. Leave a like so I know you enjoyed the video, as always, and I'll see you peeps next time.